Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. Today is Sunday, June 12th, 2022, and today we are going to be talking about the state of Alabama and the U.S. Senate election that is up this November. Now, you might be surprised to see that we are talking about the state of Alabama and a Trump endorsement and lack thereof within this race. The reason why we are talking about it is because the Republican primary is quite interesting. While Richard Shelby served alongside Senator Doug Jones in the state of Alabama, Doug Jones being a Democrat who was first elected back in 2017, lost his re-election bid in 2020, we are focused on the Republican primary and not the general election. Even though Democrats may have had a surprise showing just 5 years ago, it's not enough to say that this general election will be at all remotely competitive. The state of Alabama is a red state, and whoever wins this Republican primary is more than likely going to win the general election. That's why we're talking about this altogether. In addition to that, these Republican primaries are the most competitive part of winning an election in the state of Alabama. Whoever wins it again is likely going to win the general election. But the Republican primary is not as easily said and done as someone might think. The state of Alabama has had an incumbent in this race for decades now, and an open race provided an opportunity for many, many candidates. Now, we're going to take a look at what this Republican primary actually went through, who is running, who is now in the runoff election, and why this Trump endorsement is quite interesting and individually a spectacle looking at the state of Alabama. So, taking a look at the history in the state, right now, it is a runoff race between Katie Britt, the former president and CEO of the Business Council of Alabama, and the former chief of staff to Senator Richard Shelby. Might I add, that is the senator who is holding the seat who is choosing to vacate it at the end of his term. Mo Brooks is a U.S. representative for Alabama's 5th Congressional District who ran for Senate back in 2017. Now, this 2017 Senate bid is important for context because in this bid, the Republican Party had a multitude of candidates, but what was interesting was that this primary came down between many candidates that were looking to run in the state of Alabama. The top two contenders were Luther Strange and Roy Moore. Roy Moore was the former Chief Justice of the Alabama Supreme Court. Luther Strange was the incumbent appointed U.S. Senator and former Attorney General of Alabama. Mo Brooks was still a U.S. Representative. And in terms of endorsements, there were no major endorsements in the first round of voting. If you take a look at the, besides President Trump's, which we will talk about in a moment, but if you take a look at the eventual victor, or at least the first place winner in this primary, it was Roy Moore, and he was not endorsed by President Trump. Luther Strange, on the other hand, was endorsed by President Trump, and it made a little bit of sense. Luther Strange was the incumbent, though he was appointed and had no real electoral notability to his name. Then, when it headed off into the runoff election, Roy Moore defeated Luther Strange by a margin of about 10 percentage points. This would be one of the most consequential decisions for Alabama Republicans in quite some time, because in the general election, Doug Jones ended up defeating Roy Moore due to allegations against Roy Moore's character. But Mo Brooks was eliminated in this first round of voting. But this time it was supposed to be different. He got 20% of the vote in the previous election, but this time he was going into this 2022 race with an endorsement that he got from President Trump back in 2021. On April 7, 2021, Donald Trump endorsed Congressman Brooks. He said that he wanted him to become the next senator from the state of Alabama, and that was largely meant to clear the field. And when you take a look at the list of candidates who ended up running, it honestly did. Katie Britt was the only realistic opponent to Mo Brooks, and beyond that, nobody else was really a top contender. When you take a look at those who decided to withdraw or those who declined to run, there were some pretty notable names across the state of Alabama. But this Trump endorsement was meant to give Mo Brooks a handed victory. He was meant to be the next U.S. Senator from the state of Alabama. Even though in this initial race, what we found was that there were endorsements against Mo Brooks in the primary and for Katie Britt, the primary initially started out with an overwhelming lead for Congressman Brooks. If you take a look at the first poll ever taken immediately following the Trump endorsement, the lead for Congressman Mo Brooks was nearly 50 percentage points to the next contender. In fact, actually, it was more than anyone had even predicted, looking at the last election. It was a substantial result. 59% was completely out of the ordinary and would have completely avoided a runoff primary. But then months went on, and half a year went on, and a year went on, and voters started to split their support from Congressman Mo Brooks to other candidates, Mike Durant and Katie Britt. By the end of it, Congressman Mo Brooks did end up in the second place position by overall percentage, but the polls had seemed to back Katie Britt, and so did the voters. And with this decline in numbers, with Congressman Mo Brooks being unable to leverage the Trump endorsement too heavily, Donald Trump decided to unendorse Mo Brooks, in a move that I'm sure shocked Mo Brooks and many other Republicans, because it is rare for someone to unendorse a candidate. But Donald Trump has been infatuated over, recently at least, his margin of victories for his endorsed candidates and his percentage of success for these endorsed candidates. Now, when you take a look at the state of the race on March 23rd, 2022, look at these numbers. Congressman Mo Brooks was about to hit single digits. He was at 23, 18, 16, 12, and then the endorsement was rescinded. Looking at these numbers, it was a downward trend. He went from, at one point, defeating his biggest opponent now by a margin of 50 percentage points to a point where the only other main contender dropped out of the race, another candidate dropped out of the race, and then all of a sudden, the voters became unhappy with Congressman Mo Brooks, and they decided that they were going to back Katie Britt and Mike Durant. So, out of an idea of either self-preservation or a true shift in belief and ideology, Donald Trump withdrew his endorsement of Congressman Mo Brooks. And Mo Brooks was certainly not happy. But the numbers didn't exactly tell us that this withdrawn endorsement was going to really make Mo Brooks lose the race. When you take a look at the Republican primary results, Mo Brooks ended up doing worse than expected. He did slightly better than the polls had predicted, but the margin of loss, technical loss, between the first place candidate and the second place candidate is pretty substantial. Mo Brooks only received 29% of the vote. A lot of that can be attributed to the fact that Donald Trump decided to unendorse Congressman Mo Brooks. And not only did he unendorse Mo Brooks, he decided to endorse Katie Britt in the Alabama Senate race. It's very interesting, because Donald Trump had attacked Katie Britt in the past. There were comments that he made about her that made it seem as if he was never even going to support her, potentially in a general election even, which obviously was never the case, but what he had said was very, very interesting. He calls her a fearless America First warrior in his re-endorsement and decision to be made. But it's interesting when you take a look at the comments that were made about Katie Britt in the past. Mo Brooks slammed President Trump for this endorsement and said that Trump has made the wrong decision twice in the state of Alabama. One, endorsing Luther Strange, and two, endorsing Roy Moore, both of which lost their elections. But Donald Trump doesn't care. He said that Mo Brooks has gone woke because Mo Brooks said that the Trump supporters at his rally should move beyond the 2020 election results and say, quote, put it behind you. These are things that angered President Trump, and as a result, Donald Trump withdrew the endorsement. Mo Brooks, on the other hand, wasn't willing to just sit by and allow this Trump endorsement to go unchecked, saying that Donald Trump is the only man in American politics who could get conned by Mitch McConnell twice in an Alabama Senate race. Let's just admit it. Trump endorses the wrong people sometimes. He endorsed Mitt Romney, he endorsed John McCain, and now he's endorsed Katie Britt, who his own son, Don Jr., called Alabama's Liz Cheney. It's very interesting. It says that Alabama grassroots remember in 2017 when Donald Trump and Mitch McConnell got involved in a Senate primary in Alabama, and we rejected them. The people of Alabama will decide. It's just a very, very interesting flip and switch for President Trump, at one point saying that Katie Britt is certainly not what the state of Alabama needs. It's very interesting to see how Donald Trump really pushed away from a candidate who, he says, was not acting in his interest. But I would call BS. I think this decision to withdraw the endorsement from Mo Brooks was very much centered around the fact that Mo Brooks was not going to win this primary. Donald Trump says that he believes Mo Brooks has gone woke, that his comments on the election from back in August were the determining factor in withdrawing this endorsement. So it begs the question, why didn't you withdraw the endorsement half a year ago? The answer, Mo Brooks was riding high half a year ago, or not necessarily at least riding high as much as he was back in April following the endorsement, but certainly doing very well. The numbers had him at 41-41, and then the numbers continued to have him high at 55%. While they did eventually fall and get to a point within range for Katie Britt, what Donald Trump did instead of unendorsing Mo Brooks, he interjected himself in the race. And instead, he spoke to a candidate that seemed to be pulling votes away from Mo Brooks, Linda Blanchard. He told her to run for governor against Kay Ivey, and there was a lot of discussion about what that would do to this Senate race. Well, she withdrew from the race, and partially Donald Trump was right. Mo Brooks' numbers started to rebound. He was losing at one point in a poll by one percentage point to Katie Britt in the first round. Well, following the withdrawal from the race, Mo Brooks rose to a five-point lead, then to a five-point lead again, but Katie Britt falling behind Mo Brooks by 10 percentage points. The point being that what Donald Trump decided to do was remove someone out of the equation to try to clear the field for Mo Brooks. And then it still ended up failing. And Donald Trump, like I said, has very much been infatuated and obsessed with his ability to choose the winning candidates. He knows he's been wrong in Alabama once, and he doesn't want to be wrong again. Mo Brooks was that wrong candidate. And as confirmed by this initial round of the primary results, Katie Britt is going to be the next senator from the state of Alabama. Unless some major monumental shift happens across Republican voters in the state of Alabama, they are going to back Katie Britt. And I don't think it's because of Donald Trump's endorsement, but rather because of her own campaign skills and abilities. Katie Britt won this election for herself, not on the back of a Trump endorsement, not on the back of major endorsements, but on her ability, because she started out as the underdog. And now Donald Trump is regretting ever touching Mo Brooks within this race, because Katie Britt really showed that Trump endorsement doesn't always mean a lot. And while you can argue, sure, that the Trump withdrawal of the endorsement could have pushed down Mo Brooks' numbers in that first round, I would also like to say that the numbers before the withdrawal were showing worse numbers for Mo Brooks. Mo Brooks recovered last minute, enough so to put him across the finish line to advance to the runoff. When you take a look at these numbers, Mo Brooks got about 6% more of the vote than Michael Durant. That's not impressive for a sitting U.S. representative. In addition to the fact that in his own congressional district, he was neck and neck with Katie Britt. These are people who know and are supposed to love you, especially in a gerrymandered district like that. But still, he was only winning by just a few percentage points and sometimes was behind during the evening of election results. Looking at that, I would say, I don't see much for Mo Brooks. And it is very clear that this ability to win and this margin of victory can only be handed to Katie Britt. I think in this runoff election, it helps that the Trump endorsement was there, because it has provided needed direction. But as preliminary polls have shown in head-to-head matchups between the two candidates, in a runoff election, even before Donald Trump withdrew his endorsement of Mo Brooks, Katie Britt was still winning. In a poll a week before Donald Trump withdrew the endorsement, Katie Britt defeated Mo Brooks by a margin 51-28. That is a margin of 23 percentage points. More than likely, Donald Trump saw this poll. More than likely, Donald Trump was fearful of this poll and decided to withdraw the endorsement. The endorsement has not hit any of these polls yet. There are no runoff polls following the endorsement. And Katie Britt still maintains sometimes a 15 to 20 point lead over Mo Brooks. It's a substantial lead and it cannot be ignored. And it is very good for Katie Britt. So as we head off into this Republican primary runoff results, I want you to take in one thing. Donald Trump is very politically smart with what he does and when he does it. He realized that this endorsement could be rescinded. He could do it in time to get rid of Mo Brooks being associated with his name, because it was entirely possible. Katie Britt welcomed this endorsement, because that's all you can do when you get an endorsement from the former president of the United States. Obviously, it helps Katie Britt, and she's more than happy to have it, but she won on her own accord. Donald Trump's endorsement went back and forth within this race, to Mo Brooks, away from Mo Brooks, to Katie Britt. It was a very interesting situation. And the dynamic between these two candidates, you can really see the difference. But looking at this result of Trump's endorsement, or potentially lack thereof, a consequential result, shows that Trump's endorsement might not matter as much as we think. It matters in some states, but it doesn't in others. And what we've seen in the state of Alabama is that voters have come closer to rejecting Republicans that they have seen with the Trump endorsement for over a year by monumental amounts. And once this runoff election occurs, I can guarantee you with near certainty at this point in time, Katie Britt will win that runoff election and Mo Brooks will lose. As much as Alabama is a ruby red state, deep red conservative ideologies all across the Republican primary, Donald Trump is adored in this state, not enough so that they are willing to sacrifice who they are voting for or push away from it. It's also interesting that they no longer need to, because the front runner and leading candidate now is Katie Britt. Even though Mo Brooks might have had that endorsement previously, it is clear that Donald Trump is not happy with him now. Or maybe more so, he's not happy with the endorsement that he made in the first place. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure to comment down suggestions below. Subscribe on the left if you haven't already, and check out the Instagram and Twitter. At the bottom left of the screen, there's also a Discord server for you to go ahead and join. On the screen, there's a video you can watch and then a playlist for my 2022 midterm election analysis videos. Again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all tomorrow.